I'm going to call the regular meeting of the town board to order, and we're going to do the first order of business is a public hearing, local law, utility polls. I'm going to read the notice of public hearing. Please take notice that the town board of town of Cornwall will hold a public hearing on the 11th day of April 2016 at 7 o'clock p.m. at Town Hall, 183 Main Street, Cornwall, New York, on a proposed local law entitled "A Local Law to Amend the Town Code by Enacting a New Chapter 139 entitled Utility Polls." The local law proposes to require utilities that use town highways, streets, roads, and rights-of-way to promptly remove their plants, cables, lines, equipment, and terminals from old and damaged poles, and to further require the prompt removal of double poles once all plants, cables, lines, equipment, and terminals have been removed. A copy of the proposed local law is on file in the office of the town clerk and available for inspection by interested persons during town clerk's business hours. The town board will at the above date, time, and place hear all persons interested in the subject matter hereof. Persons may appear in person or by agent. All written communications addressed to the board must be received by the board at or prior to the public hearing. By order of the town board, town of Cornwall, not to be town clerk, dated March 16, 2016. Is there a motion to waive the reading of the public notice or the local law?
So.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Rendell?
Yes. The motion is carried. I just want to just briefly, double poles for the utility poles has become a problem throughout many areas, and certainly in Cornwall. When the utilities install a new pole, and it's usually Central Hudson, they transfer over the top wires to the new pole, cut off the top part of the old pole, and then it's up to the other companies, the cable company or telephone company, to come in, transfer their wires, and the last one off the pole is supposed to take the old pole down. The problem is that this can go on for a long period of time. And in some cases, the poles get to a point where they deteriorate and create a safety problem. And in other areas, I mean, it's unsightly, but I did have a call, one call, I've had several actually, but one call from an individual who for 9 or 10 years has been trying to get two double-poled locations at right next to his property, and he can't get any response from the other utility company. So this is a way to give the town some strength in at least going after the utilities and putting them on notice that we fully expect for safety and certainly from an aesthetic standpoint that the process should be much more expeditious than what they're currently doing. So at this point, I'm going to open the public hearing. Is there anyone from the public wishing to speak on the proposed local law? Yes. Give me your name and address to the clerk, please.
Yes, my name is Carla Castillo, and I live at 69 Hasbrook Avenue, and this is regarding the recycling, single stream recycling.
No, this is a public hearing on
double
pole
utility.
Thank you.
I thought we had moved on.
No. Yes.
Anthony Incano, 700 Rosemill Road, Cornwall. Are we passing a resolution against for the Pilgrim Pipeline, or are we just going to read?
Anthony, this is a public hearing on a local law about double utility poles. That's all this is about.
Oh, okay, fine.
Then we'll be at the
regular meeting.
Okay, anyone else?
Well,
oh, yeah, absolutely. Anyone else?
No, fine.
Okay, hear me now. There's a motion to close the public hearing. Move a second. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Gunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Okay, I should please stand to pledge the flag. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we have approval of minutes, March 14th regular meeting, March 16th special meeting, March 23rd special meeting, March 29th special meeting, and March 29th executive session meeting. Is there a motion on the minutes?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Rendell?
Yes. The motion is carried. I'll now entertain public comment on agenda items. Anyone wishing to speak on any of the agenda items?
Okay. All right. Now. Okay. I got it. Are we passing a resolution this evening with the Pilgrim Pipeline, or is just going to read some correspondence?
Basically, just give an update on, we had the meeting in Margaret Cottage, but just sort of update on the discussions and some correspondence that we've seen.
Okay, great, thank you.
We have passed resolutions, though, opposing the co-lead agency of the Thruway Authority and the...
Okay, because I do have new information in it from quite a lot of assemblymen from Albany to Rockland County that they worry like we are about our school children. There are 101 schools, private and public, that are going to be affected by this. And I have done a lot of reading, and the most effective way to transport the oil is through the pipeline. However, there is some problem. And what I'd like to have the board consider is a modified to table the existing resolution and look into a modified pipeline that will protect the schools and will protect the aquifer. But we can talk this later on in the public session, and I have new information to give.
We don't have a resolution for tonight, Tony.
Okay, great, perfect.
Anyone else?
Thank you.
Thank you, Tony. Public comment, Carla?
Carla Castillo, 69 Hasbrook Avenue. Regarding item 9, sanitation commingling recycling program, I just wanted to share some research, recent research on recycling. It's been found that clear bags are a really important aspect to recycling, whether it's recyclables that are put in clear bags or waste being put in clear bags. That raises the ability for not only the sanitation workers to see what is actually in the bag, but also encourages people through, encourages residents to only put, increases the rate of recyclables being put in recycling bins. The other thing is the importance of public education campaigns. Any large-scale recycling effort will not be anywhere near as successful without a strong public education outreach campaign. There are counties in the Mid-Hudson Valley that have reached 50% recycling rates, or in the state rather, and that's due largely to public education campaigns. So I just wanted to share those pieces of information.
Thank you. Anyone else? Public comment, agenda items? Okay, hearing no one, then we'll go to the first item on the agenda. It's a resolution on the seeker for utility poles for the local law. Whereas the town board has considered the adoption of a local law entitled Local Law to Amend Town Code by enacting a new chapter 139 entitled Utility Poles. And whereas this is an action subject to SECRA. Whereas the town board is the sole involved agency, assumes lead agency status, and as such has caused to be prepared a short environmental assessment form. Whereas following due notice, the town board has conducted a public hearing on the proposed local law and heard all persons interested in the subject matter thereof. And therefore be resolved as follows. One, that the supervisor is hereby authorized to sign the EAF, and two, that after considering all the information presented to it, including the EAF, the town board determines that the adoption of this local law is a type 2 action. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Moved by Helen, second by Peter. Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunce?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Second resolution is to adopt the utility poles local law. Whereas the town board has considered the adoption of a local law entitled Local Law to Amend Town Code by enacting a new chapter 139 entitled Utility Poles. Whereas following due notice, the town board held a public hearing on the proposed local law, and therefore be resolved as follows. That the town board does hereby adopt the above local law, which said local law shall be effective upon publication, posting, and filing in the office of the Secretary of State in Albany. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Second. Second discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunce?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next item, I had a received an email from Elizabeth Kosky, who's working on a World Award project at the school. I believe you're a junior, Elizabeth. And it's New York is a great place to be. And I'll read the proclamation. It's a topic that's interesting and actually has gotten a lot of play and news headlines over the years. Town of Cornwall proclamation, whereas Pollinator species such as thousands of species of bees are essential partners in producing much of our food supply. And whereas pollinator species provide significant environmental benefits that are necessary for maintaining healthy, diverse urban and suburban ecosystems, whereas pollination plays a vital role in the trees and plants of our community, enhancing our quality of life and creating recreational and economic development opportunities, and whereas the town of Cornwall provides recommendations to developers and residents regarding landscaping to promote wise conservation stewardship, including the protection of pollinators and maintenance of their habitats in urban and suburban environments. And now therefore, the town board of the town of Cornwall does hereby proclaim the week of June 20th, 2016 as our municipality's observance of National Pollinator Week, and urge all citizens to recognize this observance. In witness hereof, I have hereunto set my hand and cause the seal of the town of Cornwall to be affixed this 11th day of April 2016. Richard Rendazzo, supervisor. I'd ask the board for a motion to approve the proclamation.
So moved.
Your second?
Second.
Second discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Rendazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Elizabeth, I'd like to present you with the proclamation.
Some honey that you all can use in the office as sweetener in your tea or anything you wish.
Thank you very much. And thank you for bringing this to our attention.
It's from Trophy Farm, it's local.
Terrific. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, next is the Cornwall Lacrosse, the resolution on the ball court. It's been a discussion that has been before the board for a long period of time. Presentations that we've had have a resolution with regard to the project, whereas heretofore the town board received a proposal from Jacqueline McBride of Gaylor seeking approval on behalf of the lacrosse community and others in Cornwall for construction of a ball court on town grounds. And whereas in support of the proposal, a draft set of construction plans prepared by McGowan, Bowser, and Petzl were submitted on February 11, 2015. Whereas on August 12, 2014, the town board. The town board adopted a resolution approving a site within the Town Hall Park as a location for the proposed wallboard court, subject to approval of the construction plans by the town. Now therefore, be resolved as follows. One, that the town board hereby approves the construction plans for the wallboard court contingent upon submission of a set of revised construction plans modifying the February 11, 2015 plans to reflect the reduction of the wall length from 35 feet to 25 feet, changes to the fencing requirements and the footprint of the actual wallboard site. And two, that the town board finds that upon construction, the use of the wallboard court for lacrosse will be limited to the eastern side of the court with appropriate signage posted listing the limitations along with any safety rules which may hereafter be developed. And three, that the town board hereby affirmatively commits the town to accepting and allowing construction of the proposed wallboard court. Although, as is the case with all municipal improvements, no vested rights in any third parties are created by such acceptance, and the town reserves the right to make such design modifications or changes in location of the same as may be required by law or are determined in the sole discretion of the town board to be necessary or appropriate for the public welfare. And I just want to note that the couple of changes that we're looking for on the plan is the height of the fence on the eastern end overlooking the playground area would be increased to 12 feet, and that the remainder of the fence instead of 8 feet would be increased to 10 feet in height. And as was indicated, the wall has been reduced from 35 feet to 25 feet, and due to the reduction in the length of the wall, that the court itself be moved 10 feet further away from the basketball court to provide more space between the activities. And we'll ask the engineer to upgrade the plan to indicate those changes. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, the motion is carried. Next is a request, Cornwall Lacrosse Off the Wall Race. Jackie had come to the board to talk about the race, outlining that it would be 12 noon Sunday, June 12th, and last until approximately 3 p.m. They arranged to have seven or eight bands play music during this one-hour race event at various business locations on Main Street. And indicated that they would, local artists to design a mural. It says, "Our plan is not only to support this great addition to the recreation facilities, but bring sports, music, and artists all together for a great community event." And went on to describe some of the changes in the plan. Is there a motion authorizing the event?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion?
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Okay, next we have three proposed zoning changes for the town. First is local law number three. It's a local law to amend chapter 158 entitled zoning to revise certain definitions and uses permitted in the agricultural rural residential district and the mountain and conservation residence district. This just clears up some of the areas that have been in question over the years. I will read a resolution. Whereas the town board of the town of Cornwall has the local law before it entitled local law to amend town code chapter 158 entitled zoning to revise certain definitions and the uses permitted in the agricultural rural residence district and the mountain and conservation residence district. And whereas in order to take action on the said local law is necessary to schedule a public hearing to make specific referrals. And therefore be it resolved as follows. One, that the movement of this resolution is hereby introduced to the above proposed local law. Two, that the proposed local law be forwarded to the planning board of the town of Cornwall for review and report. Three, that the proposed local law be forwarded to the Orange County Department of Planning for review and report. And four, that a public hearing on the proposed local law be set for. Steve, what would you anticipate on turnaround time for the, can we do it in a month?
Well, yeah, I would think so. The planning board is going to need to have its initial meeting in May, look this over and report to you. See, you're not going to be in a position to act at your initial meeting. If you set it for the following week, you still may not be in a position to act, but you might be. So I would suggest you hold it at the first regular meeting, in May.
The public hearing?
Yes.
Wouldn't the public hearing?
Yes.
Is he held at the first regular meeting in May?
Well, there is just one regular meeting, not the workshop. Right. I mean the regular month of the meeting.
Okay. Which is, what's the date?
The 9th.
The 9th? Mm-hmm. Okay. So it'll be set for May 9th at 7:00 p.m. And that due notice of the same is directed to be given by publication and posting. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Michael?
Okay.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. This would be a proposed zoning law, local law number four. Local law to amend town code chapter 158 entitled zoning to change the zoning designation of certain real property from suburban residence district 2 to highway commercial district and to change the zoning designation of other real property from suburban residence district 2 to planned commercial development. This local law is proposed for Route 9W corridor near the New Windsor line, and it would be the easterly side of the property. And what would be proposed is in this local law is the NEMA property from Faculty Road to Route 9W would be changed from the SR2 to Highway Commercial, and the remainder of the property from Faculty Road East would be changed to planned commercial development. Read the resolution, whereas the town board of the town of Cornwall has a local law before it entitled the local law to amend town code chapter 158 entitled zoning to change the zoning designation of certain real property from suburban residential district two to the highway commercial district and change the zoning designation of other real property from suburban residential district two to planned commercial development. Whereas in order to take action on said local law is necessary to schedule a public hearing and make specific referrals, now therefore be resolved as follows. One, that the movement of this resolution is hereby introduced the above proposed local law. And two, that the proposed local law be forwarded to the planning board of the town of Cornwall for review and report. Three, that the proposed local law be forwarded to the Orange County Planning Department of Planning for review and report. And four, that a public hearing on the proposed local law is set for, again, May 9th, and we'll also set that for 7 o'clock. We'll just do one after the other. And that due notice of the same is directed to be given by publication and posting. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion's carried. The third proposed zoning change, local law number 5, a local law to amend town code chapter 158 entitled zoning to add certain uses to the uses permitted in the planned residential development TRD district as alternatives to planned adult communities. This basically is for the property at 9W up to the New Windsor line on the west side of 9W. And it's the area where the planned adult community zoning exists. And the board is looking to, that it will maintain the planned adult community zoning, but in addition to that, also add a planned commercial development for that property. That would be similar to the opposite side of the street. The front portion of it would be highway commercial. The back part of it would be the PCD. And looking at it, with 9W being the corridor, four-lane highway, having that zoning in place on both sides of 9W, and mirroring it, it really creates an area where the town ultimately could see some commercial development that would bring ratables and hopefully create some jobs in the community. So we feel that probably in the entire community, that's one of the best locations to really get significant commercial out on a state highway. So that's the purpose of this zoning change. I'll read the resolution. Whereas the town board of town of Cornwall has a local law before it entitled local law to amend town code chapter 158 entitled zoning, they add certain uses to the uses permitted in the planned residential development district as alternatives to the planned adult communities. And whereas in order to take action on said local law, it is necessary to schedule a public hearing to make specific referrals. Now therefore be resolved as follows, that the movement of this resolution is hereby introduced the proposed local law, and the proposed local law is be forwarded to the planning board of the town of Cornwall for review and report. And three, that the proposed local law be forwarded to the Orange County Department of Planning for review and report. That a public hearing on the proposed local law be set for May 9th at 7 o'clock p.m. and that due notice the same is directed to be given by publication. And I will entertain a motion on the resolution.
So moved.
Second. Move second. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion's carried.
Dick, in regard to those three local laws.
One, yes, we might do a safer.
Well, yeah, the thing is, I would think that the board would want a report from the town planner in regard to CEQA review and the various environmental issues which might be, you know, implicated by these zoning changes. So I'd ask if the board would consider it, just to adopt a resolution authorizing Garling Associates, your town planner, to prepare those reports and submit them to you.
Is there a motion on the resolution?
Second.
That one. Move and second. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Okay. Next item is on sanitation, commingling recycling program, single stream recycling. Something the town board has talked about. We met with our highway superintendent in charge of sanitation and expressed our desire for the town to go to a single stream recycling operation, and Eugene Conley, our superintendent, working with the staff, came up with a plan that they believe they can implement that will put this new program into place, and they've basically laid out routes, and we think that's a good direction for the town to go, I think, for two reasons. I think, number one, it will make it easier for our residents to actually do some recycling by being able to just single stream, put everything in a container and set it out. Second thing is that we're hopeful that it will encourage even more recycling by making it easier, streamline it, and increase our percentage of recyclables, which the more we can recycle, it lowers our costs on tipping fees for taking the garbage and disposing that at the transfer site. So we think there are real benefits that come from that. The other thing is that the, unlike it now where the garbage is picked up twice a week, cardboard is once a week, and then plastic and glass is every other week, this will make all recycling would be picked up once a week. So that would be the cardboard, the glass, and the plastic. And looking forward, we also, one of the things that we're going to consider as we watch, and many people that we've talked to, the board members as well as the public agree, that the second pickup of the week is very light in terms of maybe a bag of garbage or no real. So ultimately, we are going to then take a look at one day a week garbage pickup, which can be beneficial and free up the department to do, they want to expand even yard waste pickup and things that would make it even a little better for the community. So that's one thing that we're hoping to do. So what I would look for is for the board to approve the going to the single stream recycling based on the plan put together by the superintendent and the staff, and that we would look to start this on Monday, the 5th of June, 6th of June? I think it's the 6th of June.
Yeah, that's Monday.
Right?
Yeah.
It would be Monday, the 6th of June that we start this. And that hopefully would give us lead time that we can really publicize this and get it out every way that we can, because any change with garbage recycling, it's hard. The residents are used to a certain way, and so it's sort of an educational process, but we're hoping to be able to have plenty of time now to get that out there through multiple means to make this be successful. So I'd like to entertain a motion to authorize going to the single stream recycling program.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion?
Yes. You might assign the information distribution to the conservation committee to execute.
Yeah, I think the conservation certainly can, we've talked, I think, actually about getting the word out about recycling, so that's a great way. And I think we'll look at any other suggestions we have, I mean, website, newspaper, any means that we have just getting out there. That's why we want to give a good long lead time into really doing it. So that's fine, Michael, we look for input from the conservation committee. Okay, move the second. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
And Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. I have a memo from Highway Superintendent. As you're aware, the county has a hold on taking electronics as the vendor we both use has terminated collection for the time being. Recycling electronic has become a time-consuming operation causing problems with storage. The county's advised they would be putting this undertaking out for bid. Eugene's looking for authorization to utilize a new electronic recycling company from Glenmont, New York. The name of the company is Elot Recycle, Reuse, Recovery. They basically work the same way. Elot, they charge for transportation and a one-time fee for packing materials. Old televisions with CRT glass monitors will also have a charge of 35 cents per pound. After speaking with my company contact, the estimated cost of the municipalities he deals with is now approximately $200 plus or minus, according to the amount of televisions picked up. Attached information from the Elot for review. We've also attached information from an electronic company in California, whose charges are somewhat higher. Hesitate to utilize them, with demographics being considered. They schedule electronic pickups throughout the year approximately four times, but in the past, if the amount collected is low, we store the electronics here until the next pickup. If approved, Eli can accommodate the town as soon as we need them. There's no contract for the service, we can terminate their services at any time. Is there a motion to authorize the superintendent?
So moved.
Second. Move second, discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next, the Stacy Lyle from the Chamber has contacted the board. They would like to do music in the park on the town hall lawn. Daytime and events, they're hoping to start June 12th and have it on Sundays, running through the beginning of September from 6:30 to 8. Live music, entertainment for the community. And we've had music in the past, and I think we would welcome having that back and really appreciate the Chamber looking to bring that event to the community. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Is there a second? Move second, roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes, and we confirmed it was Sunday?
Yes. Yes, so it's definitely Sunday.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, motion is carried. Also, a request from the Chamber for the Fall Festival. This will be the 43rd Annual Fall Festival, 10 to 5, September 18th. Include retail, food vendors, entertainment. I believe they're also looking to have vendors up on Torrey, and the Chamber's assured us that they'll contact the residents well in advance to let them know that that will be part of the festival. Is there a motion to approve the event?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next, I have two resolutions on new copiers, one for the supervisor's office, one for the assessor's office. One for the supervisor's office, actually the monthly charge will drop from $249.09 to $216.86. And the assessor's office, it will remain the same at $226. So I think that I'll read the resolutions. Whereas Town of Cornwall has received a lease agreement from Rico, a copier for the supervisor's office between Rico USA Inc. and Town of Cornwall. Whereas it would be in the best interest of the town to enter into the lease, now therefore be resolved as follows. The town board hereby agrees to enter into a lease agreement for a Rico copier model MP3554SP, branding set, which lease is annexed hereto and made part of this resolution. And two, the supervisors are authorized to execute the same. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. The motion is carried. Second resolution, whereas the Town of Cornwall has received a lease agreement for Rico copier for the assessor's office between Rico USA Inc. and the Town of Cornwall, and whereas it would be in the best interest of the town to enter into the lease with Rico, now therefore be resolved as follows. Town Board hereby agrees to enter into the lease agreement copier model RICOHMPC303003, which leases the next year or two and made part of this resolution. And two, the supervisors authorized to execute the same. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Or second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call?
Mr. Russell?
Same as last year.
On the assessor, the supervisor one is going down in price.
Yeah, yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
And Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, motion is carried. A resolution on Arbor Day, whereas the Town of Cornwall recognizes the importance of trees and for many years has been proud to participate in the annual celebrations of Arbor Day and Earth Day and celebrating the 12th anniversary of being a Tree City USA town. And whereas in keeping with the Tree City USA standard requirements to qualify for membership, the town encourages trees, planting, environmental, and community pride. Now therefore be resolved as follows. One, the town board wishes to celebrate Arbor Day and Earth Day by encouraging its citizens to participate in environmental activities in keeping with the spirit of each of these days. And two, the town board wishes to recognize and celebrate the 12th anniversary of being Tree City USA town. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Moved second by Helen?
Mm-hmm. Michael moved there.
Mm-hmm. Move the tree. Move the tree. Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. have an application for a event. It's 27 Tanager, Tanager Road, Unit 4, Monroe, as the address of the applicant. The name is Shangham Ventures LLC. But BlackRock is sponsoring the event, correct?
I did want to tell you that, I know you'll be happy, Mr. Russell.
Yes.
They're changing the name to the Great Scuddy Monk Traverse. They're removing the term assault on Scuddy.
Well, that's...
Happy.
No, no, that's good. We appreciate that.
That's good.
Okay, the trail races on Scuddy Monk Mountain, a small portion of Taylor Road to utilize, as well as part of Creamery Hill Station and Star Roads. They estimate about 100 participants. No need for police, they're indicating.
And their insurance is already on file.
Insurance is on file. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, motion is carried. Last month was the first month that we were video taping the, recording the regular town board meeting, and I had a proposal from Generation Video Productions. It's the company has offered a contract and a non-contract. The contract price is $110 per hour. Start time 15 minutes before the actual start of the event. And I believe also odd times billed in quarter hour increments of stated rates below. So each 15 minutes would be an additional charge. And the editing under the contract would be $40 per hour. And uploading and hosting video content is the contract price is $15 a meeting. And these this will be available through the town's website. There'll be a link that you can go into the town's website and click on to be able to view each of the meetings. I'll read the resolution. Whereas the town is considering hiring Generation Video Productions to video record town board meetings. Whereas Generation has provided the town with a proposal for services, now therefore be resolved as follows. Town board hereby agrees to enter into an agreement with Generation as per the attached proposal, subject to the submission of a contract acceptable and form to the attorney for the town. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Michael. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Thank you. Appreciate it. Looking forward to it. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Okay, a memo from the highway superintendent. May the undersigned be authorized to enter highway and sanitation equipment, sweeper, loader, plow truck, and garbage truck in a fundraiser for the Mountainville Engine Company number 3. It's a touch a truck event that they have. The event will be held Saturday, June 11th from 12 noon to 4 p.m. in the Highland Engine Company number 1 parking lot. Equipment will be dropped off on Friday, June 10th, and picked up on Monday, June 13th, respectively, Eugene County. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Next is a letter from the New York State DEC. It's regarding the annual evaluation report, inflow and infiltration management program from the town of Cornwall. It says the department has received the 2015 inflow and infiltration INI management program evaluation report dated January 19, 2016, submitted by McGowey, Hauser, and Etzel. Consulting engineers. The INI reduction program for the year 2015 approved in a letter dated July 15, 2015 was not implemented in accordance with the approved schedule. In addition, the completion date for the INI reduction program has been extended from 2015 to 2018 and beyond without a specific end date. This report is not approvable and in violation of the speedies permit schedule of compliance. The consent order inflow and infiltration schedule of compliance states that the respondent shall implement the INI reduction work immediately in accordance with the approved schedule. The approved schedule in 2014 inflow and infiltration monitoring annual report approved by the department in a letter dated July 15, 2015 was not implemented. It is a violation of the consent order requirement. Please submit an approvable report to the department by March 31, 2016. The department anticipates your compliance with the requirements of the speedies program, which we take into consideration before making a final determination regarding appropriate enforcement actions for the violations. Should you have any questions, contact it's the engineer with DEC. McGowey, Hauser, Etzel has already submitted the updated plan. Apparently what happened last year was the town went out to bid for repair work on 12 to 14 manholes. I don't believe there were any contractors that bid on that work. They went out and bid on televising work on some of the sewer mains. They did receive a contract, I think it was a bid, they took a low bid of $17,000 and change. Unfortunately, the engineer stated that the onset of winter made it difficult for the company to carry this out. So they're the two reasons that the work did not take place in 2015, but we certainly will be expecting the contractor that has the contract for the televising to do that in the very near future, and also look for a contractor to do the work on the manholes. And I think along with the multi-million dollar upgrade of the sewer plant, one of the problems that most municipalities have, it is the aging, you know, sewer collection system, which really does require engineering. And our engineers, I will say, I've looked at the work that they've done over the past couple of years. They've really come up with great plans and identified markers throughout, and really have a good handle on it. So we're hoping that with the report they sent to the DEC, that they'll understand that we realize that we have to move on this, and that you know, we will make it a priority going forward. Again, unfortunately, these are difficult times. This does require money, but the town has no choice but to do everything we can to remain in compliance with the DEC requirements. So during the year, I'm sure the engineer is going to be presenting us with the next phase of the INI work, and the board will have to certainly move forward with that. So I just want to note that for the record, and we can continue to work on that with the DEC. Pilgrim Pipeline correspondence. I did receive a copy of a letter that came from a law firm representing the Pilgrim Pipeline that was sent to Mr. Kent Sanders, Deputy Chief Permit Administrator, New York State Department of Environment and Conservation. It's a long letter basically saying that the towns that sent in letters, either somewhat indicating they'd like to be lead agents or opposing the pipeline. They give all the reasons why they really shouldn't even take that into consideration. And the bottom line is that their general feeling is that the co-lead agency that's been designated by the DEC to be the DEC and the Thruway Authority is the appropriate lead agency that they support. And they indicate that in the event that there's a decision made by DEC that it should only be one agency, they're certainly recommending that the Thruway Authority be that lead agency. And I think, you know, this project is really very troubling, certainly for the town of Cornwall and our residents, and for everyone in the Hudson Valley and up and down the line. We really are wondering where our representation is in Albany, starting with the governor, that a project like this would even be considered in this day and age, when we're hoping to move away from the fossil fuels and becoming with renewable sources of energy. We did have a meeting over at Munger Cottage and had a presentation by a couple of individuals. Everyone's trying to stay on top of this. There's just no real sign of any real consideration for the residents in the communities coming out of Albany. And so we can't really let our guard down. I think we have to do everything we can. We've sent in resolutions opposing it, opposing the co-lead agency. And it's something that working with the other municipalities, we really have to stay engaged in. Obviously, we talk about the railroad line along the river where the cars are transporting the Bakken oils, which is known to be very hazardous. And now they want to sort of box us in with this pipeline coming down to the western part of our community, taking not only the oil down, but bringing back refined products. And we really should be concerned about the health, safety, and welfare of our residents. And certainly, this is a challenge to our environment if, in fact, there is any breach of that pipeline. There are two major aquifers out in the Mountain Hill area alongside the Thruway that are really relied on for sources of water for the community. And any kind of a major spill could certainly have a dramatic impact on the water supplies, as well as all of the individual private wells that are around that area. So I think that we have to continue to be vigilant on this, working with the other communities, and somehow we have to get some indication from Albany as to why they continue to pursue this, or they will not just put a stop to it. It's the New York State Thruway that they're looking to put this pipeline down, and it's easy, the governor should just step forward and say that that pipeline is not going to be constructed in New York State, going down the New York State Thruway. If he would do that, it would save all of our residents and all the municipalities from having to expend time, money, and energy to fight a project that no one in the Hudson Valley is ever going to benefit from. And that really does threaten the our quality of life in our area. So it's just disheartening to, you know, to elect people to represent us. And clearly, it always comes down to dollars and cents. And you can rest assured that the Thruway is in for a lot of money if this project ever goes through. And unfortunately, the governor is putting money over people. And that is totally unacceptable. So we have to get that message to the governor and let him know that we are not going to just sit back and let our government threaten our own safety here in our community in the Hudson Valley. So it's something we really have to be passionate about, because it just doesn't make sense. So I wanted to let the board know that. The correspondence is Pilgrim's a big company with a lot of money and certainly a vested interest in doing this project. So we have to drive our stake in the ground and really be forceful about it. And the board's been very supportive on every step that we can take with it. The one thing I do want to mention, because at the meeting at Munger, it did come up about people from Pilgrim representatives going to property owners and talking about getting easements and being able to win in surveying and all. And they really have no right to do that. So what we're asking our residents to do is to please call the supervisor's office. If any of the property owners along the pipeline way have been contacted by anyone who's trying to survey or get easements or whatever from their property, because we would like to track that so that we can really see what areas they're looking at. I think that's really important to us. And we want to let our residents know they have no obligation to allow anyone on their property. And if people are persistent in coming back, they should make a phone call to the police department and talk to the police about someone coming out and wanting to go on their property, or going on their property if that's what they find. But they have no obligation to do it, and certainly we would encourage them not to allow anything like that at this point. So we ask them to call the supervisor's office, let them know who they are and where their property is.
Can I mention something?
Sure.
Anyone who actually does sign a lease with a pipeline company, you may not know, but your mortgage or may take away the financing and require you to pay your mortgage immediately. And your insurance company may not insure you if there's a pipeline running through your property or if you've signed paperwork to that effect. So two things we aware of.
Be aware. Thank you. Two projects that we have, we are out for quotes on the rain garden to be constructed by the behind Wayne's Pond. That's due, I think we have bid openings.
22nd, April 22nd.
And the second one is we are out to bid on the Sands Ring Homestead roof project. That also is going to go in on the 22nd. So we're looking forward to both of those projects hopefully coming in and so that we can move ahead with them. The request from the Highway Superintendent, may the undersigned be authorized to attend subject training June 6th, 7th, and 8th. We held it at the college, at the New York, and utilize the town vehicle plus fuel to and from. Costs are $110 for the school, and lodging Sunday through Tuesday is $447. Funds are available in fiscal year 2016 appropriations. Respectfully submitted, Eugene Conley. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Andeza?
Yes. Motion is carried. The next on the Solar Liberty project. This is the solar project that the board has been looking at to be constructed out on Holleran Road, on property that the town acquired. The town has been working with Solar Liberty. An RFP went out last year, and they are the ones who were successful with the RFP. And I have talked to the village of Cornwall on Hudson. They've voted to join us in this solar project in terms of the benefits of it, and also the our library. They're at a point where they're going to be making a decision whether they will join. I reached out and talked to the school district, and they were very interested, but unfortunately, as the project moves along, we find there are a couple of factors that enter into it. When initially it was looked at, the project for the solar panels was going to take 3 to 4 acres to meet the town's needs. Then when we added in the village and the library, that number increased up to about 10 acres of property. And then when the village looked at it, or the school district, and expressed interest, and the calculation was done, it actually almost doubled what the needs were going to be, and that would put it up to 20 acres. But what we found is that the property that we can use for this project due to wetlands and all is limited to the 10 or 11 acres. So right now it is the town, the village, and the library will be making a decision very shortly. And even though this has been around for a few months, we're really reaching a crossroads where final proposals are being put together, contract is being looked at, and whatever negotiating we can do, and we intend to do some negotiating with the company that would be the ones to build and operate this, that will be going on over the next few weeks, because we really have to move on it, because the credits that the state has put out for these contractors actually started out in block one, block two, now they're actually in block three, so they seem to be going very quickly. So we're at a point where we're going to try to get all the information we need so that we can make a decision on it. And so we'll keep everyone informed of that, and then the board, as soon as we get the information, we'll get together and go over it and make that final decision. So we're hoping that that it can go forward, and the town can save, we project, a lot of money over the next 20 years or 25 years that this project would be in operation. So I have next a first resolution is, actually we adopted a resolution for consulting services of Russell Budd, and he's modified the agreement. It originally was for a maximum of $25,000. He's now reduced it not to exceed $23,800, but we adopted a resolution. So is there, a motion that we would amend the resolution to reflect the maximum of $23,800. For his consulting services. This is with regard to the sewer plant. Mm-hmm. Is there a second?
Second.
Move, second. Discussion, roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Andazza?
Yes. Motion is carried. Now the second contract is with Hawkins, Delafield, and Wood. They are the bonding company that we use for the bonds. I'll just read part of the letter. It says, our fees to date for EFC, we were doing the funding through HELP loan, was $2,250, and five prior bond participation notes, $6,819.89, include the preparation of proceedings under Section 202B of Town Law in 2011. The total prior fees prior to bond anticipation notes issued pursuant to the 2011 202B proceedings and the HELP loan are $9,069.89. Our prior fees relating to the sewer project authorized in 2015 include preparation of additional proceedings under Section 202B of Town Law. The total prior fees for the 2015 sewer project are $7,036.25. We understand that the town will now require an additional proceeding under Section 202B of Town Law and an amended bond resolution to reflect an increase in cost. Our fees in connection with the proposed new combined EFC financing, including the additional 202B proceeding, will not exceed $16,750, including all out-of-pocket expenses and disbursements. In addition, we would charge a fee of $1,200 for any EFC grid note, which would provide temporary financing through the EFC. As you know, the EFC has requested that the town provide a document signed on behalf of the town and this firm, confirming our representation and fee arrangement, signed by Robert Smith. I read the resolution, whereas the town board has received the attached retainer agreements between the town of Cornwall. Well, actually, we did put Russell Budd in here.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm sorry, I missed that one. And Hawkins, Delafield, Wood, in connection with the improvements to the Cornwall sewage treatment plant. And whereas these agreements supersede and replace the prior retainer agreements related to this project, whereas the town board has undertaken to make improvements to the wastewater treatment plant and requires consultations and advice in regards to obtaining the funding for the same, now therefore be resolved as follows. The town board hereby agrees to enter into the next agreement And two, the town board hereby authorize the supervisor to execute the same and all documents necessary to effectuate the terms therein. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call?
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Blunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Okay, that's all we need on those, Steve. I think these are the last agreements that we need to get the EFC, correct?
Yeah, we're all set.
Okay. Personnel, I have a memo from Karen Budusky, reference Cornwall Farmers Market. I'm ready to inform you that market manager Carrie Savins will resign her position as manager when the position has been filled at the end of the winter market, whichever should happen first. However, she'd like to continue as a market vendor. She thanks all of you for the opportunity that you have given her. Is there a motion to accept?
So moved.
Second.
Roll call?
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Blunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes, motion's carried. Joe's last name, Romero?
Yes.
Yes. Next we have which position which is really crucial to the town is the director of the pool for the summer. It is because it's such a responsible position, and we've had Joe Romero for a number of years has been the director and responsible for the supervision of the lifeguards and for the pool facility itself. He's very familiar with it, and Joe is available to come back this year and has agreed to serve from May through the end of August until Labor Day, the waiting pool opens to the big pool, the waiting pool closing. So I certainly recommend to the board that we appoint Joe as the pool director with the salary for the entire season, providing all the supervision at a salary of $10,000 for the entire season.
So moved.
There's a second? Discussion? Roll call?
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Blunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Surplus vehicles. I have a memo from the building inspector. Surplus vehicle 2000 Jeep Cherokee. We request that the town board declare the 2000 Jeep Cherokee vehicle surplus. And I have a letter from highway superintendent recommending that the 1998 Chevy pickup 3500 for the highway department and the 1995 International Packer Sanitation Department be declared surplus. After an evaluation of the 2004 International Packers body, it would be in the interest of the town to sell with the truck. This is what Eugene was thinking of switching something over, but now he's decided that it should be sold with the truck and put on gov deals. Is there a motion to declare these three vehicles surplus and put them up for sale?
So moved.
Second.
Second discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Blunt?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. And a memo from the chief regarding intermunicipal agreement with Orange County. Resolution, whereas the town has received a proposed intermunicipal agreement between the County of Orange and the Town of Cornwall regarding the 2015 State Law Enforcement Terrorism Prevention Program. Whereas the agreement would permit the county to provide the town with one mobile data terminal and related peripherals for use in a town patrol vehicle. Whereas the chief of police recommended that the town enter into the agreement with the county, now therefore be resolved as follows. That the town board hereby agrees to enter into the next intermunicipal agreement between the county and the town and authorize the supervisor to execute the agreement and forward the same to the County of Orange. Is there a motion on the resolution?
So moved.
A second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
The point that there's no cost to the town.
No cost to the town. It is through Homeland Security.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. We have warrant number four. Is there a motion to approve the warrant?
So moved.
A second?
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bunn?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Randazzo?
Yes. Motion is carried. Public comment on any issues? Yes, Carla?
I apologize. I failed to make one key point regarding the clear trash bags. The clear bags for trash specifically is to also reduce contamination. There is what the industry is finding is that contamination is reducing their profits, and some of the private waste facilities are actually closing down as a result. And the public waste facilities are going to most likely become much more stringent about what they accept, that the recyclables that are received are actually high quality recyclables, and having clear trash bags to distinguish between what is in the trash that should belong in the recycling bin, or what's in recycling should go in the trash, will help the town provide the high-quality recyclables that the county waste facility will need.
Thank you. Anyone else? Yes.
Okay. My name is Virginia Scott. I live at 36 Willow Avenue. I have two thank yous. First, thank you for checking into the certified letter being received, both of them. The second one, Mr. Randazzo, I would like to thank you for meeting with my husband regarding our revaluation on our property. Out of the three supervisors, one stuck his head in the sand, the other one refused to even meet with my husband, and you, I do appreciate me, because that's what an elected official should be doing.
Thank you.
The only thing I had, something clarification, I wasn't there at the meeting, the town board appoints the assessor, is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. But the town board has no power to discipline or reprimand if, in fact, the assessor has been acting in an illegal manner.
Well, when you use the word illegal, that
well, it's proven to be.
The town board
if there's no, what I'm, I guess what I'm trying to get to, let me finish my point. I shouldn't have used the word illegal. Okay.
Right.
I guess the statement was there, the town board has really no power to discipline him if he is acting in a way that's not appropriate. Is that better?
Well, yes, let me put it
okay.
in English.
I just want to finish my point.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay.
You still have more?
Well, you know what? I've had this since the year,
she
what, 2011. So I think I have the right. My question is, where is the system of checks and balances? We went further. We met with Mr. John McCary, who is the Orange County official with Real Properties. Mr. Fiorentino, the assessor, basically told my husband that Mr. McCary was his boss. My husband met with Mr. McCary. Mr. Keck McCary said that's not true. He's not his boss. He looked at our information and said that he was going to give him a stern talking to, which I'm not sure if that's, if it's really going to happen. I'm kind of losing faith in the system. But again, in a democratic society, I just want to know, where is the system of checks and balances? I now have to pay for another appraisal on my property. So when I have my officials tell me, don't worry, the reval's coming, for someone who has been paying more than my fair share of taxes since 2013, it doesn't make me feel any better. I'm not alone in this. And I really hope other people who see this or in this audience start talking, because I'm not alone in this. I'm not the only person. I'm just the only person who's talking about it. Thank you. I really do appreciate you meeting.
Thank you. Anyone else?
I will.
About what the young lady said, I share her, appreciate her comments, because I had my own problem with Ron. And that I don't want to discuss that tonight, you know, because I'm leaning in bringing in our 1278. Against them, but that's not the subject I want to talk about tonight. And unfortunately, I know I had to pick my concerns in it, because ever since I came to Cornwall in 1979, I already picked what, 2-3 different items that we worked on for years. And I hope that one of these days I'm going to pick an easy one. But anyway, on the what caught my attention to the Pilgrim Pipeline, again, was a letter that I happened to read by from someone else. And it really got my attention. And it reads the following. It seems that nearly every day, in the ragged or elsewhere, we are reading about a town, a city, county, or group of citizens opposed to anything that delivers fuel or energy, or improves infrastructure in any way. If a pipeline, power line, or delivery system, or any type, comes anywhere near us, we are automatically against it, for a myriad of reasons. I wonder where we will be today as a society if in the late 19th century and early 20th centuries, our assessors had objected to the placement of poles carrying communication and power lines or pipeline for natural gas, sewer, or water. What if a pole fell on someone, started a fire, electrocuting a person or an animal? We can't have that. Don't forget that ugly and they ruined the landscape. Let's not forget how dangerous those natural gas lines can be. They can leak and smell pretty bad too. I dare say that these utilities not being allowed to be constructed, our civilization today would be much different. Had our ancestors not taken a leap of faith and embraced rather than demonized technology, we most likely not be watching supersized television in our comfortable homes. Instead, we might still be cooking whale oil and wood for cooking and coal for heating in a 21st century more closely resemble the 19th century. I didn't write this. It was written, and I got it from the record in one of the letters, by Michael J. Lansbury in New Falls. That got me thinking, what are we leaving our children? First, we're living in a country now that there's almost no jobs. And I have been traveling to Mexico, I've been down in El Salvador, I've been down in Honduras, and I work with some of the largest companies that have set up plants in China. Every single American job has a bullseye. Everyone is against us because they want our jobs. Now, in Cornwall, what do we have? And let me back up a little bit. I live in on Worst Mill Road, so I'm much closer to the pipeline, which will be running over the thruway, than I will be by the train. But what are we leaving our children? I'm concerned that my children actually are grown up, but my grandchildren, which go to Mrs. Bond's school there, and I hope my little one will be going there, I'm concerned for their safety, as all of us are. Now, when you make a decision on something that important, what do you base that on? On information. And you balance the risks from one system to another. And last Monday, I gave you some stuff. It wasn't too thick. About the problem with this is new material that I just found, and I thought that I was one of the very few people that was concerned about this, but I found that everyone from Albany to Rockland County is worried about this. And if you read the names of all the assembly people from Albany all the way down to Rockland, there is a lot of people. That's what our politicians are doing in Albany. You including the United Teacher Union. Because we're gonna be required, Mrs. Bonte is gonna be one of the ones, that you're gonna have to have emergency drill. If the pipeline is not passed, they're still gonna get the oil down to the East Coast. It's not gonna be stopped. So how is it gonna go? By barges or by the railroad? And that's what the problem is, the railroad. Phillip Refinery in Linden, they have already a plan to double the size of the railroad cars, up to 3,700. And they're going to be shipping the oil from North Dakota to Chicago, and then it's going to get, going to go to the west or to the east refinery. So we're going to be looking at a lot of oil train, and we're not going to have anything to say about it. But there's a lot of people now that are starting to unite, and hopefully we can fight this. What I propose, instead of passing a resolution simply damning the Pilgrim Pipeline, let's ask and work all together with all these other people that are involved in here. Let's ask for a modified pipeline. What do I mean by that? We have barges that they have a dual wall. We have ships that they have a double hull. And does anyone, by the way, anyone knows that the first barge that left Albany ran aground 6 miles south of Albany, but there wasn't a single drop of oil spill because of the double hull? So if that is a protection, why can't we have a double pipeline, double wall pipeline in area where it is sensitive by aquifer, by rivers, by near populated area? And maybe that will bridge the gap. I agree with Richard, we should start working toward the solars and wind things, but it'll take 30 to 50 years before we get there. Now, I took the liberty of, I didn't want to bother, you mind if I start?
Yeah, time, you can sort of move it along.
All right, I'm almost done.
No, that's fine.
There is a lot.
I realize it could be an hour or 2 hour session, but because there is a lot of information, and we recognize that, and we value your opinion. So, you know, we do want to hear from you, but sort of, you know, wrap it up.
I took the liberty, I didn't want to bother Mr. Larkins because he's been sick, but I took the liberty of calling, sending an email to our assemblyman, James, from Woodbury, and I explained basically the same thing I just told you. And he answered me back, and he said, Mr. Incano, I know that Cornwall is against the pipeline. If the board decide to change and support a modified pipeline, I will be there to back the position. So the first step starts with you guys. I'll work my heart out, as I have always done. In every project that we took on, the odds was 1,000 to 1 with the Highland Treatment Plant. But we all pulled together and we made it happen. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Tony. Appreciate it. Anyone else? Okay, we'll do committee reports.
Okay, from the building department, permits issued 19, CCs issued 12, COs issued 3, no demolition, no blasting, on-site inspections 39, complaints 7, stop work orders none, notice of violations 21, fire inspections 32, court appearance 1, signs removed 3, permit fees $4,211, no permit renewal fees, fees for municipal search $2,100, and planning board projects opened 2, zoning board projects opened 1. COVAC had 52 calls last month. Do you have anything else you want to add for COVAC?
No.
And the recreation, well, the seniors, not the recreation, but the seniors, she's posted her calendar. I'm not going to read that out.
Okay.
And we'll be meeting with Recreation Department and the bus driver to get the best use for the seniors.
Yes. And with that, I'm going to move to the board meeting on Thursday, 14th, in a work session to just continue to meet with department heads about and review department operations.
I don't know if you want to put on record your meeting with COVAC, but I guess you need to.
Okay, yes, I did. As a matter of fact, I did meet with Kovac regarding their contract with the town, and that's actually, we're going to be going into executive session and seeking the advice of council, so I told Kovac we will get back to them, and what we're looking for is a long-term solution to quality ambulance service in the town of Cornwall, and we certainly want to make every effort to work with Kovac. It's got a long history in Cornwall, and this board also wants to fulfill its obligations to the community to assure the community of a quality ambulance service that will be available when they need it. So these are interesting but absolutely essential talks because it certainly affects the direction that we will be going with ambulance service for the community. So, anything else, Tom?
No, I'm good.
Councilman Summerfield?
The Cornwall Conservation Advisory Council met. I received an email today from Assemblyman Scoofus and the assistant to the regional director of the DOT. The culvert work has been completed on Route 218 and as well as the sinkhole, and the Route 218 is now open. Regarding the graffiti, New York State Department of Transportation has been working with a graffiti remover solution, environmentally friendly, and pressure washed it, but it didn't take off all the graffiti. So they're going to come back with another solution sometime in the near future, and they will advise on how that process proceeds. We did cancel the Earth Day celebration, which was to be a roadside cleanup and a bike and hike on Route 218. We weren't sure whether the road would be open, so we've rescheduled. We're going to reschedule the cleanup for sometime in May, and we'll readdress the bike and hike. We do have some issues with the insurance, but hopefully we'll overcome that. Most of the meeting was taken up discussing electronics and recycling that was brought up in the town meeting. And we submitted the mission statement and bylaws. You guys got them in the email today. We can discuss that at the work session.
Great.
So for the Economic Advisory Committee, there had to have been several dozen different projects that were on our list of things to filter and decide what our priorities were. We did finish the mission statement. We narrowed down the potential projects and different things that we wanted to address for the town. That will be concluded at the upcoming meeting next Wednesday, or in 2 Wednesdays from now. So we'll have a better presentation of what our goals and objectives will be for the Economic Development Advisory Committee. And as an aside, as part of our education, we have a list of different groups that are going to be coming to visit us at these meetings. The first one is going to be Gary Vinson to give us a clear idea of how zoning works, what businesses are allowed on Main Street, and how we can make changes to improve the economic development process in Cornwall.
Okay. Councilman Russell.
It came out for the First Cliff plant. They had routine maintenance, and on March 15th, the EPA performed an inspection at the site. No report yet on the results of the inspection. There was also an issue on Harold Avenue when telescopic work was done, and then that was resolved. And as far as parameters, they were within permit limits for all parameters for that plant. And for Shore Road, routine maintenance and within all parameters, within permit limits, sorry, for all parameters for that plant. The police department, again, we went over the MDT that we got donated from the county for the grant. And then as far as for March, there were 820 calls for service, 7,950 miles driven, 29 motor vehicle accidents were reported, 23 alarms, 19 ambulance requests, 12 disabled vehicles, 21 house checks, and 21 assists of other agencies, just to highlight some of the statistics. And one of my favorite, the rec department. Here we go. Little Maestros, another music session focusing on percussion instruments while teaching music concepts through movement, singing, and listening, and playing rhythm instruments. Thursday, May 5th through June 9th at the Senior Community Center, $55 per child, and there's two sessions. So we call the rec departments for time and for ages. Then at Fit Mama Boot Camp, Tuesdays and Thursdays, April 12th through May 19th, from 9 to 9:45 at Laurel Crest Park. It's $70 for a 6-week session, or $25 for 3 classes. This is an outdoor workout group for parents to exercise with their children up to age 3. And a Mohegan Sun trip scheduled for Tuesday, May 3rd. Depart Town Hall at 8 a.m. And there's also an 8:15 pickup at Idlewild Creek Apartments, returning at 7:15 p.m. $35 per person. Payment is required to hold your seat. Last day of registration is April 28th. And they need a minimum of 32. Otherwise, they'll need to cancel the trip and they'll offer a refund.
Okay, thank you. Councilman Gates, thanks.
The Highway Department, this past month, they installed cold patch townwide, assisted the Sanitation Department as always, cleaned trucks and equipment, cleared storm drains townwide, helped with yard waste pickup, cleaned roadside brush, chipped branches and trees, Taylor Road and Jackson Avenue, and cleaned up around the Highway Department garage inside and out. The Assessor's Office, the data collectors are continuing, including the two new ones from the county that we received, and they're somewhat less than 1,000 properties to go. The entering of the data collected is ongoing and will continue after the data collectors have completed their work. And the assessor will be in contact with our subcontractor for the reassessment very shortly. As we continue to mention, we anticipate this being done in 2017, and hopefully that will be the case.
Be the target, we hope.
Thank you. Right.
Anything else, Karen?
No. Okay.
I just mentioned that I met with the trustees of the Sands Ring. We're going to meet again this Wednesday. Hopefully they will select a chairperson for the trustees that they will recommend to the town board, and we'll make that appointment. So. At this point, I'd like to have a motion to go into executive session to seek the advice of counsel. Second. Roll call.
Mr. Russell?
Yes.
Mr. McGinnis?
Yes.
Ms. Bones?
Yes.
Mr. Summerfield?
Yes.
Mr. Rondell?
Yes. Motion is carried. We will not be taking any action in the executive session. Thank you very much.